Next, we need to create a CAM profile. Before moving on to that, in the previous session, I forgot to mention the remaining 50 mm is also a dwell, okay? Second dwell after angle of return. We'll go to the CAM profile. For the CAM profile, you're having minimum radius of CAM is 25 mm, means diameter is 50. So that is your base circle. This red color circle indicates a base circle. Next, pink color circle, so that is cam shaft. Okay, cam shaft diameter you are having 25, so it is 25 mm diameter. Next base circle is 50 mm diameter, and the next one is prime circle. Okay, in case of knife edged follower, you don't have any prime circle, but here in case of roller follower, the trace point is exactly at the middle of roller. So that is why you need to find out prime circle radius. How to find out prime circle radius? It is very easy. First, you need to consider the radius of base circle, that is 25. Okay, 25 mm is the radius of base circle plus radius of roller. Roller is of diameter 20 mm, so radius becomes 10. So 25 plus 10 is equal to 35 mm is the radius of the prime circle, and the diameter is 70 mm. So likewise, you need to create three circle with the same center of rotation. Okay, we'll go to the next step. In the next step, you draw vertical line. Okay, at the end of vertical line, at the top, you draw a roller which is having a diameter of 20 mm. Okay, here is the center of rotation. From that center of rotation, you draw a circle of 20 mm diameter. It is a roller, and then you create this portion, that is follower attachment. It's of any length, it doesn't matter. After creating this, from the vertical axis, you measure 120 degree in anti-clockwise direction, because the cam is rotating in clockwise direction. Okay, so if it is rotating in clockwise direction, means you have to follow anti-clockwise direction for the cam profile. Now 120 degree is the angle of rise. Next, 30 degree. After 120 degree, next 30 degree is for first dwell, and next 60 degree is for angle of return, and the remaining part 150 degree is for second dwell. Okay, likewise, you divide, and this division line is having maximum length of 85 mm. Okay, it's like a radius of the prime circle plus maximum stroke length, that is 50 plus 35. You get maximum 85. So likewise, you divide and draw the line. In the next step, you divide angle of rise into 6 equal parts, because in the displacement drawing we divide into 6 equal parts only. So that means this 120 degree into 6 equal parts, that is 20 degree each. Using your protractor, divide this angle of rise into 6 equal parts and draw the lines. So likewise, you divide this 60 degree angle of return into again 6 equal parts, that is 10 degree each. So like this, then you will get line like this. Okay, project a line like this from each point, so that you will get tracing points 0, 1, 2. These are not the tracing points, these are the points on the prime circle. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, for the angle of return, 6-5-, it's in reverse order, 4-3-2-1-0-. In the next step, we measured distance of 0 to A is equal to 0, 1 to B is equal to 3.35 from the displacement drawing. I'll show you. See here, 0 to A is 0, 1 to B is 3.35. It is same for angle of rise and as well as angle of return. Okay, then 2 to C is 12.5. okay, 3 to D is 25. So likewise, to the respective points, I have a table for this. Okay, for my convention, I took a table, but you can directly transfer all the displacements by using your compass, okay, from the displacement drawing. Okay, here I'm using this table. 0 to A 0, 1 to B is 3.35, 2 to C is 12.5, and 3 to D is 25, next 4 to E is 37.5. So you draw arc, okay, from each points. 5 to F is 46.65, likewise 6 to G is 50, that is equal to stroke length. And then for angle of return, it is in reverse order, okay. 6 dash to G dash 50, 5 dash to F dash 46.65, because both are having simple harmonic motion, okay. So complete this likewise. After completing this, draw a curve which is passing through all these points, means capital A, capital B, capital C, where this arc intersect in this projected line, okay. So these are called as tracing points, okay. These are called as tracing point, and this curve is called as pitch curve, okay. In case of a knife edge forearm, you won't get any pitch curve. In case of roller forearm, you will get pitch curve as well as prime circle, okay. In the next step, after getting pitch curve,